What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Rayweather back here with another online gameplay here. We're going to do a regs gameplay. I still get a lot of requests to do regs gameplays, and most of the gameplays that you see coming for the rest of the year, I will have a few, you know, more here and there to edit. Most of them are going to be regs gameplays because I'm done with MUD for the year. But I do enjoy playing regs. It is nice to kind of switch it up and go back to a playing field where, like, all the teams are kind of even and you have disadvantages. You know, you have defenders that aren't the best and they don't jump every route and, you know, things like that. I mean, honestly, you know, regs does play pretty crappy in my opinion because the defense is so bad on regs. But it is, it's like, again, it's kind of nice in a sense of it gives you a challenge. So I'm running with the Chiefs. This guy's running with the Falcons. As a Saints fan, I hate the Falcons, so I definitely want to win this game more than usual. But I like the Chiefs. You know, we got Eric Berry out there. He does have 91 zone, so at least we have somebody that, you know, is capable of jumping routes. So here I'm kind of just playing the cover four, you know, all-out coverage defense that I posted a while back where I actually, you know, have nine guys in coverage. But because it's a cover four, it still does a pretty good job of containing the run. And, you know, I switch different things up. Sometimes I man random guys up or, you know, I switch up the zones a little bit. I don't run it the same every single play. But, yeah, so, you know, he's driving down the field pretty good right now. He's nickel and diming me, you know, putting a good drive together. So can't really fault him or say anything bad about him here. He throws it into some coverage. Guy kind of drops the ball. He did thread the needle. That probably should have been a catch, honestly. You know, it was tight, but he did get it in there, and he threaded the needle pretty nicely. But, you know, he wound up not being able to complete the catch. Here he's no huddling a little bit, so We're in that area of the field where it is harder to score now. So even though he was nickel and diming me down the field, now he's in a situation where it's a little bit tighter. The windows are a little bit, you know, harder to get the ball into. Here he throws it. Did he get the first down? It's going to be close, but he actually gets inches and he no huddles. So, you know, already he's in field goal range. He could take the lead, but he's going to gamble here and try to get the first down. So I'm just kind of switching my coverages up so he doesn't get too used to anything. And here he tries to throw it, but I believe that might have been Revis who came in and kind of swatted the ball down there. So he did have a window there, but, I mean, my cornerback made a really good play there. So now, you know, he passed up 3 points. So now, you know, it's time for me to go take the lead or at least try to. Here I scramble out with Alex Smith because he wasn't respecting it. This guy pretty much ran nickel 3-3-5 Tampa 2, literally. I think he ran it every play of the game. He was just one of those guys that, you know, he knows the one good defense, and of course that was one of the more popular defenses this year, but I wouldn't say it's the best, but it's definitely one of the more popular ones. And, you know, that's just the play that he learned, whether he learned it from YouTube or Twitch or wherever, you know, he might have learned it from. And he's just that guy that says, I'm going to run this every single play. I'm running this Tampa 2 every single play. I'm going to try to get the pressure off the edge. If it comes, great. If not, you know, whatever. And, you know, sometimes it came in unblocked, which, you know, happens with this play. It can be hard to block sometimes. Sometimes it didn't come in. And when it didn't come in, I was able to dot him up pretty easily. But, yeah, he didn't deviate at all. He never really went to, like, a cover three or, you know, a cover four or really anything. Here, hitting him with the halfback zone, one of the best plays in the game. I ran a lot of pistol bunch tight end. I was in the Saints playbook. I switched it up from the Packers because I wanted to run some pistol bunch tight end and some, you know, single back toss and things like that. So, but you'll see me running a lot of pistol bunch tight end in this video. And if you want, you know, to check it out, I did release the Pistol Bunch Tight End ebook. It's really one of the best formations in the game, in my opinion, that goes overlooked. A lot of people like Gun Bunch, but Pistol Bunch Tight End is very hard to defend if you know what you're doing. I'll have the ebook linked in the description and in the comments. It's only $4.99. I dropped all the ebooks down to $4.99. So, I mean, if you want to check it out, you know, it doesn't really get much cheaper than that. So here, you know, he winds up clamping me up a little bit there, forcing me to take the three. So low scoring game at first. You know, his first drive took a lot of time, and my first drive took a good bit of time. So that took most of the time off of the clock. So, but I mean, I'm good with it. I get ball at half. So, you know, just trying to go into half with the lead, that'd be really good. So now this guy, he starts running the ball. The pass worked for him last drive until he got in a situation where it didn't work. And now he's going to the triple option, and here he breaks a nice one with Coleman, and he's just continuing to no huddle out of this pistol formation, running the triple option and then running like a little halfback zone to Freeman. And he's just, so far he's having success, so he's sticking to it here. He hits, you know, Freeman again. He gets to the edge. I kind of timed my user a little bad there, but I don't think I would have caught him anyway because my guy was pretty slow. And he goes untouched for a touchdown. So just like that, a quick change of events, you know. I was up 3-0, and then just like that, boom, you know, easy touchdown. So now I got to get down the field here, starting the playoff nice, hitting the corner route there. And back to the pistol bunch tight end. Like I said, one of my favorite formations in the game this year. And, you know, just dinking and dunking down the field. Here, I wanted to pick up a little bit more than that, but I'm fine with a field goal because I know that I'm coming out of half with the ball. But I accidentally left chew clock on, and this is when I noticed and I called timeout. So I literally just killed half of the clock I had left. I had about 50 seconds left. And just like that, now I'm at 25. So I really just hurt myself there. Here I take off with Alex Smith because, again, he was running that Tampa 2, and he was just not putting a spy on the field. And he was giving me that a lot this game. And when I noticed that, I took it. So, yeah, I'm just looking to get a field goal, honestly. Here, another good dot. Luckily, I kind of get out of bounds there. I tried to spin and you know, see if I could fake him out. But I get out of bounds, so I save a timeout. So now we're actually in a situation where we might be able to score a touchdown. Here, I hit the drag. And, again, I get out of bounds. I'm upfield at the 10-yard line. So even though I killed half of my clock by accident, I'm actually in a situation where I can score the touchdown. Here, again, take off with Alex Smith, and I'm just going all the way. I'm not sliding. He unfortunately gets me down at the 2. I was just going balls to the wall there. Instead of taking the 3, I decided to just go for it, honestly. I say, you know what, I got all the way down here. Let's go for it. I go for the halfback zone, and I get in there untouched. Halfback zone out of pistol bunch tight end, definitely one of the best runs in the game, in my opinion. Maybe the best run. I really love that run. I like it better than the toss, and, I mean, the stretch is really good as well in this year's game, but I really like that run. Again, taking off with Alex Smith. I mean, he's just leaving it open. He's running the Tampa 2. 3-3-5 every single play. He's not switching it up. But what was unfortunate is normally I use the Green Bay playbook, and I have a ton of just like cover 2 destroyers out of the Green Bay playbook. In the Saints playbook, I mean, I have some cover 2 beaters, sure, but I don't have like my favorite cover 2 beaters, my go-to cover 2 beaters out of this book. So at times I was like, you know, dinking and dunking, kind of slowing down here on 4th and 4. That was another big situation. He could have got the ball back and took the momentum, but I went for it, and I threw it into some tight coverage, but was able to get the first down. But yeah, like, I don't have my patented, like, really big money go-to cover 2 beaters in this book. I mean, I have decent cover 2 beaters, so that kind of slowed me down a little bit because I was so used to the Green Bay book, and I just happened to switch up for this game because I just wanted to run something a little bit different. But yeah, either way, though, we're still playing good here. I go for the screen, probably the best screen in the game, the pistol bunch tight end screen. Like I said, the formation's just good. I mean, I can't really praise it enough. But we're just driving down the field. If I can get a touchdown here, I mean, I'm taking my time with this drive. You know, that's the thing with the cover, too. Here he gets a sack. That's the thing with the cover, too. I mean, it's definitely easy enough to beat, but it's one of those defenses that a lot of times makes you take the 4 to 5 yard gain. And here he sends the cover, too. Again, the blitz off the edge. That time it came untouched. So now I'm in another 4th and long. I'm honestly not sure why I'm going for it here. I couldn't tell you why, and I get coverage sacked again. Someone block shedded. Not sure at the point in time why I went for it there. I should have punted that, especially being up. But I think I was just frustrated. And then here, he gets me for the touchdown. I was baseline impressed. I really thought he was going to run the ball, but I guess he noticed it and switched to the pass. So just like that, I mean, this game has been momentum swing after momentum swing as I take off yet again with Alex Smith because he's leaving it there. But you know, I put together a good drive, you know, a long drive, and then, you know, he got the run for a touchdown. You know, I put together another good drive, converted a 4th down, but then he stopped me eventually, and then, boom, 1-play touchdown because, you know, again, that was my fault, though. I was baseline impressed. I really thought he was going to run. I wasn't worried about the pass, and he proved me wrong there. So here I motion over Tyreek Hill. I'm trying to go for this little particular setup to beat cover 2, but I noticed there's no one over the top, and then I think he accidentally might have even ran commit. So, bam, 1-play touchdown. We strike right back. So, again, it's just momentum swing after momentum swing in this game. Just kind of crazy how back and forth it's been. So, here he's just going back to the run. And, you know, I'm okay with letting him run this. I feel like I can stop it. He got me the first, you know, that first drive with it. But I'm more prepared to stop it now. I'm in the cover 4. And, you know, if he wants to get these little bitty yards down the field and just hope that he breaks one, I mean, that's fine here. Pop him on the hit stick, and that is mine. I pick it up. There's no one in front of me. We're going to walk into the touchdown. So now this game is pretty much done. Now we're up 2 possessions, and, you know, that was his drive. He was just hoping to break one of those runs, I feel like. And, you know, I was locking it up. Here we got to the 4th down, and I laid the hit stick. Unfortunate for him. He fumbled, and he's still running. And, you know, this is just how the game is for a lot of people this year. Like, he's in a situation where he really needs to pass, but the run is so good this year that people will continue to run the ball even in situations where they need to pass because they're just praying that they break one. Either they break a tackle, or, you know, they pull off a juke and go to the house, or, you know, they just go untouched. And he's just consistently running the ball. I mean, he's almost got a minute left in the game, and he needs 2 possessions to score, and he's still running the ball, getting 3 yards a pop, just ticking his time away. And it's just, It's just a really good, like, I guess, what's the word I'm looking for? It just sums up this year. You know, people will run the ball even when they have to pass because they would rather pray for the long touchdown run than to actually, you know, surgically move down the field because they're just simply not as good at passing. So here he goes for a play action finally and throws it into some coverage. Probably should have been picked, but, you know, I'll take the incompletion. But again, now we're down to 40 seconds left. And, I mean, any chance that he had is pretty much gone because, I mean, even if he gets a one-play touchdown right here, I mean, and even if he gets the ball back, you know, he still only has a few plays to score because he's run all of his own time off. So, again, here we are in another fourth down. Just going to try to lock this up and put an end to the game. He's taking his time, calling out some hot routes here. What's he going to do? And he does all that and play action, and he's rolling around, and he dots me. So, that was a questionable throw. He decides to go for the field goal, which is a smart thing to do. Try to get the onside kick and hopefully throw up a Hail Mary or something. So just got to recover the onside kick, which I do, and that's pretty much all she wrote. So, yeah, I mean, maybe if he would have tried to pass the ball a little bit, he could have actually, you know, who knows what could have happened. But he went all out run with 2 minutes left in the game, you know, down two possessions. Not the smartest thing to do, but that's just something people do this year that they're just scared to pass the ball, like even in situations where you need to pass. I don't understand it, but that's the game this year. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, as always, just drop a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.